important to emphasize is that from afar, Chela has been an inspiration to all of us going into lupus, especially, you know, myself and others as a woman going into academics, into medicine. She's been an inspiration to us, someone that we can model our careers and lives after. And even though she often didn't work directly with us, she was always there to give advice. Chela became very instrumental, and still is instrumental, in the LCTC consortium, where she took many of us under her wing, and again, was always there to provide mentorship in an unwavering way, in a very generous way. We now have the pleasure of having Chela in the San Francisco Bay Area, which we feel very fortunate about. It's been a pleasure getting to know her better there. So thank you for all that you have done for lupus patients, lupus research, and for all of us in medicine. And we're so proud to be able to give this to you today.
Very honored to receive this. I didn't know about it because I was told I didn't read the program in advance. So I had no idea. But when in 1993, actually, I was at UAB and the then chairman of, no, chief of rheumatology said, there's an opportunity to study lupus in minorities. You can do it, you know, just put your grant, you know, I'm sure you come with an idea and whatnot, and you can become the next lupus queen. That's what he said. That's what. Okay, so we applied, and we actually did initiate the Lumina cohort that had a difference to others, had a Hispanic group, you know, at that time, really. We knew it was lupus was bad in Hispanics, but that was not in the literature yet. From either North America or South America. So we team up with people from Mexico, and not Mexico, excuse me, from Texas, almost Mexico, and from Puerto Rico, and we developed the Lumina cohort, which has been very productive. I must say that without the support of the Kirkman Fund, we wouldn't have had the fellows that came to work in the Lumina cohort. I think that one is here. Guillermo was here, and then when I retired in 2009, I went back to Peru, and I, you know, I'm kind of restless, so I didn't think I could really retire. So I have worked with a Glaber cohort now, many of them are here, and kind of helping them out, you know, whatever projects they have and whatnot. And then I start going on rounds at the university and whatnot. And then for whatever reason, I think I inherited a few fellows in Peru. One of them is here, Manuel. And I'm still doing what I like to do. I'm not directly involved in patient care, but I'm really trying to do that through the fellows I train and to the people I work and collaborate with. Thank you so much for what you do for me, and thank you.